Good morning, dear children. Today we are continuing our lesson, that is adaptation in animals which live in desert. So we know many of the animals living in the desert areas without any problem. Can we live like that? Never, because that animals have their own adaptations to live in such an extreme condition, that is very hot and dry condition. So you know which are the animals are there in such desert conditions? Yes, you first of all in your mind the animal that is camel is coming into your mind. Then some other animals are kangaroo rats, then some desert rats, like that. Some other animals also living in desert areas. Okay, so we know the rats mainly they are living in the holes, or they are making their burrows. So in the desert areas also these rat species all are living, mostly they are living in the burrows. So when we are making house under the soil, it is so cold. So to reduce that desert condition, or to reduce the hot condition, they are making homes under the ground. So that make them safe when they are living in desert areas. Understand? So that is one of the adaptation. They are living in under the ground. They are making burrows in under the ground and live there. Then when we talk about the camel, their skin is very thick to reduce this hotness, or the at night time it is so cold also. So it is the extreme conditions, extreme atmospheric condition. To reduce that, they have thick skin to reduce the hotness and to reduce the coolness in that area. So that is one of the adaptation. They have thick skin, and most of the animals are living in burrows. Okay, then when we come to the features of camel, we know when we talk about the camel, it's a very important feature, that is the hump on the back of the camel's backside. We can see a very big hump. What is there inside the hump? They store fat inside the hump. For what they are storing fat? It is the desert area. All of you know it is the desert area. All the time they do not get the proper food, water, etc. So why? When they get food, they eat a lot, and the food may be converted to fat and it is stored in the hump. In this hump, what is the fat will be there. Okay, using that fat they are living when they do not get any food or water. Then we know they drink a lot of water, plenty of water one time itself. When they get water at once itself, they are drinking plenty of water. That also help them to survive in that atmospheric condition. Okay, hot condition. Then their eyebrows and eyelashes. We know we have eyebrows and eyelashes here. So what is it? How is their eyebrows and eyelashes? You can see the video, then you will get more clear idea about it. Their eyebrows and eyelashes are very thick. Especially the eyebrows are very thick. Why it is like that? For what purpose? You know, it is the desert area. Lot of sand will be there around them. Then always wind also will be there. Then what will be the wind? How was the wind? The wind has lot of dust. So that wind will be dusty wind. Always dusty wind will be there. Then some dusty wind will come towards us. What will happen? All the dust will come into our eyes to protect them. That is an adaptation of these type of animals like camels. Their eyebrows are very thick and their eyelashes are double layered and all. So they can prevent. They can prevent the dusty wind in that desert area. Okay, their eyebrows are very thick. Then they have very thick eyelashes also. Okay, then their padded feet. You know padded feet? Some animals like cows, goats, etc. have the padded feet. Their feet is padded feet. So these padded feet helps them to walk. This also, these padded feet is covered with skin also. Then that help these animals to walk very safely in the on the sand. So these padded feet help them to not to sink in the soil. They can walk very properly on the sand. It will not sink down. Do not sink in the sand. That is why padded feet also one of the adaptation of this type of animals which live in desert area. So which are they? They have thick skin. First one, what if you say? Thick skin. Then most of the animals, the very small animals like rats, live in burrows that reduce the hotness there. Then especially camels adaptation, they have the hump that is for storage of fat inside the hump when they do not get food. Then next is their eyebrows and eyelashes. Then their padded feet help them to walk on the sand. And they drink plenty of water when they get water. They drink plenty of water. These are the important features or important adaptations of the camels and the animals.
First, we will look at the camel. This mammal resides in the hot desert where sand blows everywhere. Luckily, they have double rows of extra long eyelashes and thick eyebrows to help keep sand out of their eyes. They also have the ability to close their nostrils to keep the sand out. It is a misconception that camels' humps are full of water. The humps actually store fat that can be metabolized as a source of energy. The tan color of a camel's coat allows them to blend into their environment.
We learned about different kinds of animals, then their adaptations. We already completed the aquatic animals and their adaptations, then the terrestrial animals which live in polar regions and the animals which live in desert areas. So terrestrial animals, aquatic animals over. Then next is amphibians. Amphibians and their adaptations. So if you know what are which are the animals we call amphibians, what are amphibians? Which live both in water and on land. They are called amphibians. Okay. So when we say the amphibian, which organism came into your mind? Well, if you say amphibian, yes, that is frog. When we talk about the adaptations of amphibians, we are talking about the frog. So do you notice any adaptations they have to live both in water and on land? Small front legs and front limbs or forelimbs and long hind limbs. Because when they are on land, they are usually using this limbs for movement. Then their short limbs, short forelimbs help them to stay on the land and their body will be up. And like that, their hind limbs help them to jump. Very easily they can jump using their hind limbs. Okay. That is one of the adaptations. The limbs of the amphibians, the short front legs and the long hind legs. And they have webbed feet too when they are in water. That the webbed feet help them to move in the water. Have you noticed? Yes. So this is one of the adaptations. Their limbs. Okay. Then their breathing. To live both in water and on land, they have two systems of breathing. You know, everybody of you know, they have lungs when they are on land. When they are on land, they breathe through their lungs. When they are in water, they use their skin for breathing. So when they are using their skin, when they are in water, that type of breathing is called cutaneous breathing. Well, if you say cutaneous breathing, again, what is that breathing? Cutaneous breathing. So that is the amphibians breathe through their skin. The amphibians, not only amphibians, many organisms are breathing through their skin. Like earthworm, like that, organisms breathe through their skin. So that type of breathing we can call cutaneous breathing. Okay, don't forget cutaneous breathing. Then next adaptation is the eyelids. Eyelids we all have are eyelids. So apart from this two eyelids, because of two eyelids we can close our eyes. Apart from this two eyelids, they have one more eyelid, third eyelid. That third eyelid, when you notice closely, you can see that one lid come in throughout the eye, in front of the eye, you can see. That eyelid help them to see the underground water and help them to prevent the water enter into their eye. When they are in water, they want to move in the water. So they can see underground of this water, and that prevent the water to enter into their eyes. That is another adaptation, because they are living in water. So they have the third eyelid, that is nictitating membrane. What is that? Nictitating membrane. Well, if you say nictitating membrane, that is the third eyelid, that is transparent. Then when it is transparent only, they can look or they can see the underground things in the water. So that is about the adaptations of amphibians. So this some of the adaptations, you know, they have the short front legs and long hind limbs to walk on the land, and they have webbed feet which help them to move in the water. Then their breathing, how they are breathing, using lungs or their skin. When they are in the water, they use their skin to breathe. That we can call cutaneous breathing. What is that? Cutaneous breathing. Then their eyelid. Eyelid also helps them to live in water or move in water. Which this third eyelid, we can call it is third eyelid. That is nictitating membrane. What is that? Let me say nictitating membrane. This is transparent that helps the frog or the amphibians to see the underground things, because it is transparent and it helps them to prevent the water to enter into their eyes. Okay, understand all of you? Read your textbook thoroughly, and one choose the correct answer is there in your textbook that we can discuss in the next class. All of you just read and try to do that exercise. Exercise means choose the correct answer in the page number 159 and read these two questions: the desert animals, animals live in desert, and the amphibians. The later portion we can take next class. Okay, thank you.